Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Oh. First of all, I want to thank everyone for coming to share my Bat Mitzvah with me. Thank you so much to those who flew in, and thank you to those who drove here, and thank you to those who had to reschedule your annual auditions. Thank you to Josh, Rabbi Mari, and Cantor Woman for working with me for months and trusting me and not getting too upset when I had to reschedule a lesson for a dislocated knee, a rehearsal, a concussion, or working with me when I said there's no way to squeeze in a lesson during tech week. Thank you for trusting me that I would get it done. Thank you to my mom and dad for supporting me and not getting too frustrated when it seemed like I was struggling to balance shows, school, guitar, piano, obsessing over Neil Patrick Harris and How I Met Your Mother, and Bat Mitzvah stuff. Mostly, thank you for just always being there for being there, supporting me, and trusting me to do it my way. My tour portion is Ha'azinu, and most of it is actually a song. Moses sings a song to the Jewish people that he was leading into Israel. He knows that they have all worked hard to get to the land of Israel, and that even though he was going to lead them to enter Israel, he will never see it, and he will die while they got to enter Israel. Moses thinks about their experiences together. He reminds them of all the wonderful things they have done together, and he also reminds them of some of the not-so-things they have done, and how it feels so much better to make good choices and not bad choices. Moses reminds them that even though they might make mistakes and God will get angry at them, God will always love them and always take care of them. At first, I had a hard time understanding my Torah portion. But after meeting with Rabbi Mari, I realized how much of it applied to my life and how much I understood it. First of all, the fact that Moses chose a song as a way to inspire and teach his people is exactly the way I think I learn best. If someone is talking or lecturing, I tend to zone out. But when I hear a song, I really am able to listen to the lyrics and know what they mean. Whether I'm trying to study for a test in school, or whether I'm learning a script for a show, or whether I was studying for my Bat Mitzvah, when it comes to learning, I do best in a song. Whether it's a real song or something I make up, I love to learn by singing and listening to music. Secondly, when Moses talks about people making mistakes, I think he means that it is just part of life, and sometimes we learn most important lessons when we make mistakes. And when you make mistakes, it is always important to know that those around you will still love you and support you. I also think that Moses is a brave and selfless leader. Even though he knows he's going to die, he still leads his people into Israel and wants to motivate and inspire them to have this wonderful experience, all while knowing he won't get to be a part of it. It is not about him, but about making sure others have this life-changing opportunity to go to Israel and to be free. I'm really, really lucky to have parents, teachers, friends, families, and others that help me learn from my mistakes and don't make me feel that they're not always making a good decision. They help me and give me the confidence that it is okay to mess up, and that makes me more confident to make a better choice the next time. An example of great advice and support I get from my family is what my Uncle Rick calls the greatest life lesson anyone can ever learn. There are three rules in life that you never want to forget. One, chicks are weird. Two, men are pigs. And three, when in doubt, see rule number one. While I think these rules are supposed to be funny, I also think that they are meant to help you in life when times are tough in social issues or in any issues. I really relate to this to how Moses spoke to his people. The whole time, Moses knew he would die before he could enter Israel, but Moses still gave his people advice on how to live a great life and make right decisions. I think that the slaves were really grateful for the advice Moses gave them and will always reflect on them when they are in a sticky situation. In my own opinion, my uncle is like Moses. Even though I know and he knows that there will be a point he is no longer with me, he still gave me great advice to look upon when I'm in a tough and sticky situation. But on a more serious note, I would like to tell you about my Bat Mitzvah project. While attending a live show certainly isn't the same from going to slavery to freedom, for some kids it can be a life-changing experience. This is what my Bat Mitzvah project is all about. In partnership with the Audrey Johnson Foundation and other stages, I'm trying to raise about $2,700 to fill every seat in the theater for kids who have never seen a live performance to come and watch Annie Jr. at other stages. In addition to watching the show with the funds raised, the kids will get to meet the cast and have dinner with them and take pictures with them. I know to those of us who are at theater or friends of ours who come all the time, this might not seem like a big deal, But I know when I was four years old, I saw my very first show at Desert Stages, the Butterfly State. It was a huge deal. I remember the costumes, the singing, the dancing, and being amazed that the kids were actually performers. I thought they were famous, and it was the most wonderful thing ever. A few years later, when I saw Wizard of Oz at Desert Stages and saw Rachel Bradley as the witch, I thought it was even more amazing than I did the first time. The acting was incredible, and I couldn't believe a nice girl like Rachel could ever act so incredible to be a witch. I want kids who can't afford this to have the same feelings I had the first time I saw live theater, to be amazed. The best performance of project I could come up with is to mix my two favorite passions together, theater and helping kids. So maybe it is not about leading people into freedom. With lots of help from family and friends and even some strangers I don't know, I am excited about leading kids into an amazing lifetime experience of seeing live theater and maybe have their lives touched like mine was the first time. Thank you.